A famous explorer once said that the extraordinary is in what we do, not who we are. I'd finally set out to make my mark, to find adventure. But instead, adventure found me. When life flashes before us, we find something. Something that keeps us going.
Hey guys, welcome to The Good, The Bad, The OMG. I'm your host, James, aka Wade D. McGinnis. Today we're going to be looking at Tomb Raider for the PC. Now, just get this out there. Okay, so the story is really the gameplay, the main story is what you're really going to be probably buying the game for. While the multiplayer is in the game, it is kind of still mediocre at best, and I'll get to that eventually. So, I'm going to start out with story. The reboot starts with Lara Croft searching for the Lost Kingdom of Yamatai. Having an entire cast of somewhat stereotypical characters, the crew head to a stormy region called the Dragon's Triangle, the game's version of the Bermuda Triangle. Things take a turn for the worse when the ship sinks, the crew becomes scattered, and Lara is then forced to explore, survive, and overcome the harshness of this mysterious island. After completing the tutorial, players will encounter the main villain, Matthias, and begin to understand this island has dangers that are both real and mystical. Near the end of the game, players will be witnessing a number of impressive and terrifying creatures while you battle to save yourself and your friends. Without spoiling too much, the ending does give players a feeling of accomplishment mixed with empowerment, and truly has you eagerly awaiting the next installment. And you will wait, and you will want to wait. It'll hurt, but you'll want to wait. The gameplay takes a page from Uncharted, mixing in the cinematic, almost movie-like action sequences with a few QuickTime events to amp up the action. While people will groan over another game using QTEs, Tomb Raider primarily uses them to progress the story without slamming you with them over and over. The main combat of the game is moving between cover and shooting. The interesting feature found in the game, though, is Lara will actually go into cover the moment she reaches something large enough to cover her. She will even lean out to get a better shot of a target, adding to the immersion. While each firefight is fairly scripted, players will find a nice variety in taking down enemies. For example, players can try to shoot as many enemies with a bow, or do takedowns to reduce the enemy count, sometimes even sneaking past a firefight if the game will allow. The downside is the game will never let you completely go stealth if that's what you're looking for. So no Dishonored, sorry. For those wanting to shoot as many targets as possible, however, the game does a great job in making you feel the pressure of a fight while still making it fun. I was out of my chair during the heavy firefights, running between cover and shooting, weapon swapping, the whole nine yards, and just screaming at my TV to get her to go in and take out as many guys as possible. Now, you can't have a Tomb Raider game without caves, hidden areas, and general exploring. While the past games have always felt linear because either the nature of the console at the time or the heavy focus on room-to-room play, here players will find a sense of linearity, but the tombs or the caves you encounter are optional versus forced. While the main story still has a few areas with interesting puzzles and climbable areas, it's the side tombs and caves that really test your climbing puzzle-solving skills. And yes, it is odd to get a gun mod from a tomb no one has seen for hundreds of years, but you get a lot of fun out of solving the puzzle, and the enhancement or the potential enhancement you get from the reward just adds to the overall fun. The reward system in the game, so the skill tree that you can get to upgrade Lara's abilities to combat enemies, to her surviving, to her generally just using the weapons that she has at her disposal, to salvaging, you know, more salvage, getting more experience, to her actually upgrading her weapons both visually and just more dynamically, more powerful. It's all fun. It's actually, it really is engaging, and I found it enjoyable, but for those that were expecting something a little bit more dynamic. That's not exactly what you're going to find here, but it is still enough as a starter for the next game to be even more dynamic in upgrading and modifying weapons and modifying her as a character. The environment. The island is varied visually. I was surprised and excited to see a number of different environmental changes to the zones. Yes, you will repeat certain zones, but the zone will be altered somehow. Typically night or day, or some weather effect. And you'll also have the addition of some kind of weapon or tool that you found throughout the story that alters the way you progress in the game. Things like using your bow to make a rope bridge between two points, or tearing down a door, or using those same tools to like yank an enemy from the cliff. It all adds and modifies and just enhances the game experience. You're going to see areas of the game that are truly breathtaking, and then areas that truly have your sense of fear kind of build at the base of your spine. It's not entirely a horror game, but it has that semi-impact that you're not too sure what to expect around the corner. The AI does the job. Yes, there are moments where they glitch out or do things that just look pure idiotic, but for the most part, they will challenge you as a player if you have it at the highest difficulty. They will try to work together to get you killed, and when you find yourself in the later levels fighting things that are not entirely from this world, you'll scream in frustration because you weren't paying attention and some guy got the drop on you and you just didn't see him and you're dead because of it. Trust me, it'll happen. The voice acting in the game is well executed. While the supporting cast is like general characters you would normally see in a B-flick movie, the acting behind the characters makes you feel something. I will admit I would have liked to spend more time with the supporting cast to truly build a connection before they are shredded by some environmental danger or some enemy or to make that last stand, but the cam recordings that Lara goes through, those flashbacks that you essentially get, does add something to the game, and it does add something to the character, and it does definitely add something to Lara. The voice acting that she actually goes through, the actress that plays Lara, is the best voice acting I've ever seen out of any of the Tomb Raider games, period. Truly, you see a very impressive evolution of the character from this weak-willed, unsure woman to a very strong-willed, determined, and almost gung-ho action-style hero that gamers know and love. The difficulty, I would have liked to have a harder difficulty setting than what is found in the game. I felt hard is where normal should be. While I was taxed at certain points of the game, feeling the tension, I never truly felt completely challenged until near the end of the game where things were hitting the fan and it was do or die. The multiplayer I kept trying to get into. I really wanted to enjoy it, but I found myself going back to the main game to get all the collectibles I missed, or picking up a more polished and engaging multiplayer. What they have here is interesting, but it's still very mediocre. The added traps and the ability to scale along walls is fun, but you'll find yourself routinely paired with better players who will mow you down without a second notice. Mix in the latency issues or the frame rate issue if you're using an NVIDIA card, and you can find yourself calling it quits early on. If you stick it out to get better weapons or abilities to level the playing field, however, then you might find something here to enjoy, but to be honest, the real reason to probably buy Tomb Raider is for that single campaign, that story experience. Bugs! Now, the PC has its ups and downs when it comes to bugs. Since I have an NVIDIA card, I experience the drops in frames, the texture walls, fires lit when Lara has not lit them, to even having the game crash. Now, NVIDIA has since been patching to support the game with their cards, and the improvements they have made have greatly increased the stability of the game. However, you're still going to probably encounter most of these issues just because that's the core functionality of the game. To be honest, I haven't really found a situation where it has stopped me from playing, or in general just caused a game-breaking bug to occur where I just couldn't progress forward. If my game crashed, I just simply got back onto it. If I had some issues with latency or texture walls, I just kind of pushed on through it. If it was a fire that was lit prematurely or an enemy doing the jig while he's still dead, it was more of a nice little giggle than anything else. Still not really completely acceptable, but it is the standard that we've kind of grown to be accustomed to with games nowadays. My final thoughts on this game is, if you have been waiting for a solid Tomb Raider game, this is definitely where you should pick up. If you have not played Tomb Raider and you've just been eyeing it over the past decade, give or take, then I highly suggest playing this game, buying this game. If you're on the fence completely, go out and rent it. If you can, go get a copy from a buddy, a girlfriend, a wife, you know, your brother, your sister, whatever the case may be. All in all, this game's actually a really good start to a Tomb Raider series. Yes, it is mixed in with Uncharted, and there are some things that they totally increase upon, improve upon, you know. A more dynamic weapon system upgrade would be nice. While the zones, going bouncing between the zones and getting all the collectibles is nice, having maybe a larger area or possibly larger side tombs or more dynamic puzzles, while the puzzles are still challenging, something a little bit higher, and having a better, more adequate difficulty would be nice. Something a little harder would be also be kind of nice. But the story, though, the story is really kind of, that hits it home for me. Still maintains the roots of Tomb Raider. It's got that mystical aspect, and really watching Lara grow as a character was something to just experience and enjoy the whole time. Hopefully you guys liked the review. Leave some comments below letting me know your thoughts on what you thought of the game and whether or not you play the multiplayer and everything in between. And I'll, as always, I will catch you guys next time.